Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have almost no standard SpaceX updates for this video. However, we have some interesting Florida Starship information and activity in Boca, Chica, mostly with Starships. So let's head straight in and get up to date. We have this great shot from Julia Bergeron to begin the video. This is booster B1060, which flew Starlink 11 and it returned to Port Canaveral on Sunday, so will now be prepared for its third flight. As I said, almost nothing for standard updates. Over in Boca Chica though, we have some action starting with the new wall. You can see how long it is now, and I think it's cool that they found a use for the scrap they've got. At the moment, the wall is not doing a very good job of blocking our view, so here's a shot of behind. You can see those newly built bunkers just behind the wall and shipping containers. Not far away from there is the launch mount where SN6 was recently sitting, and you can see the newly poured concrete below the mount. Also, there is the arrival of a new pipe for the ground support equipment. Looking at the mount after the 150 meter hop, it's a bit damaged but looking pretty good in general. Probably won't need much work before it will be ready for testing at some point. I'm thinking SN5 will be back on it next. Whilst SN6 was being prepared to be rolled back and SN7.1 prepared to roll out, the mount at Pad B was still being worked on. Shouldn't be long at all before it's up and running for testing. Looking at launch mounts, we also have the new orbital mount being constructed. They are about halfway through with constructing the supports for the structure. Over in the construction yard, the high bay construction for Super Heavy is continuing. Workers were spotted doing stuff at the top of the building as they prepare to add a roof in the not too distant future. Moving on, as I said earlier, we have some interesting information about the Starship site in Florida. For those who don't know, many months ago, SpaceX were building a Starship in Florida which was recently seen being deconstructed. However, Julia Bergeron has now tweeted this great picture of something new that has arrived at the site. She tweeted the picture saying, "A pure stream flash unit has been added to the SpaceX Sidco Road facility. This unit uses evaporation to handle wastewater from manufacturing processes. It seems that Sidco may become a manufacturing facility, with the question being what part of Starship would they support?" Somebody responded to say that it could be Starship heat shield tiles, since apparently SpaceX have a listing for a Starship heat shield technician. So, looking at SN6, which recently lifted off and flew 150 meters in the air, has recently been preparing to move. You can see here that a crane was hooked up to the prototype to lift it. Before they lifted it, the pipe stands were moved into position for further post-hop work. The tank was then lifted and placed back down onto the pipe stand so engineers could work on the legs. The legs were then retracted and detached so SN6 could be placed onto the transport mount on the roll lift. Once the engineers had done everything to prepare the tank to be moved, it was then lifted and placed back down onto the transport mount. Before the tank could be moved though, they had to bolt the bottom of it to the mount. So they finally moved the SN6 prototype back to the construction yard to meet up with SN5 once again. Here's a fantastic shot of the two tanks together, having both completed one 150 meter hop each. Whilst SN6 was being rolled back, SN7.1 was continuing to be prepared in the yard. Made of the new 304L stainless steel and I believe a new thrust puck too, this tank is destined to pop under an immense amount of pressure. Shortly after SN6 had been delivered back to the production area, SN7.1 was placed on the roll lift. Even though SN7.1 has already arrived, the pad wasn't quite ready and so the tank was moved just near to it. Meanwhile, engineers continue to work on the pad in preparation for the testing. I hope SpaceX can reach a much higher pressure than SN7 did. However, Elon Musk never told us what pressure the SN7 tank reached, and may not for this test tank either. For the SN7.1 testing, Cameron County have posted some new dates with a primary closure of tomorrow, Thursday 10th. There's also SN7.1 testing dates for September 14th, 15th and 16th. To finish up today's video, we also have some SN10 action which I didn't expect to happen just yet. Here you can see the upper bulkhead for the methane tank was seen sitting on a sleeving mount outside. On top of this, a four-ring stack, which in of itself is interesting, was moved outside so they can sleeve these components. I believe all of the upper ring stacks for previous vehicles have been just three rings, so this is different. The ring stack was then lifted and moved over to the bulkhead for sleeving. So now that these two have been sleeved with one another, SpaceX will start welding the first section of SN10. The final thing I want to show you is this absolutely awesome shot of three different Starships hanging out in Boca Chica, two of which have completed a 150 meter hop each. Just consider that this time last year, not even SN1 existed. Now they are working on sleeving parts for SN10. As always, a massive thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Girl who goes out there and films in the scorching Texas heat daily. She and the whole NASA spaceflight crew do an incredible job with all their space coverage and live stream, so a massive thanks to each and every one of you. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.